Hello, Dr. Wendelin Hume here with another Star of Your Dreams videos. And today I'd like to talk with you about spasticity. And that may have been something you've heard about or maybe not, but this week we're trying to raise awareness. It is National Spasticity Week from the 17th through the 22nd, I believe. So I'm partnering with groups like the American Stroke Association.org, if you want to check them out online, some good resources, and some other groups that are just trying to raise awareness about this condition that affects over 12 million people worldwide. Not only does it affect a lot of people, but one of those people happens to be me. So I'm kind of in a unique position that I'm able to help out and help spread and raise awareness at least a little bit about this condition that affects so many people. Now, usually you'll see spasticity after perhaps like a stroke because it's triggered by brain damage. But that also means that, you know, a car accident, a bad fall, other things that may damage the brain as well can cause spasticity. And what spasticity is a disruption in the communication from your brain, which sends messages down your spinal column and nerve endings to the major muscle groups, all your muscle groups, to tell you how to move, right? Move your fingers, move your arm, move your wrist, all those types of things. And so it sends this communication. And the problem with spasticity is sometimes that communication is disrupted and you may find it hard to be able, for one thing, for me at first, to even move at all. But once you get that movement, you might be able to focus, look at it, and think about moving the affected limb so that you can think about it and move that arm or leg or what have you. But when you're not focusing and your brain's just kind of randomly shooting things, not quite as organized as it used to be, you'll find that it causes severe muscle cramping, like a bad Charlie horse, but one that doesn't let go, one that doesn't release. And it can affect different parts of the body depending on the person. So one of the things that you'll often see, and you may have noticed it in people in a store or something like what is with that, is that you'll see just a naturally kind of inward tightened hand. Sometimes when the cramps are real severe, it may even cause your wrist to bend in, and even your arm. It'll be in kind of like a bent shape, often kind of towards the chest. So that's just it's sending muscle signals to contract, and it makes it difficult to hold a spoon right type if all the time the brain signals are to contract. And you'll see that this can affect an arm, it can affect a leg, a foot, toes, whatever it may be. Now, it's not all hopeless. There are a variety of things that can be done to help spasticity. Certain medications can help. A lot of natural things, relaxation, hypnosis. If you really need to, things like braces, electronic devices that send, you strap them on and it'll send little electrical impulses to counter the impulses being sent by the brain so that you can open or swing your leg or move. You might see people wearing those little devices. Other braces might help. Sometimes just simple stretching, like during a bad instance of cramping, make sure that the person has something that they can squeeze so that they're not cutting their fingernails into their palm. Make sure they have something across their chest, that they're not scratching their chest. A lot of times what will help is simple things like stretching exercises. Help counteract that signal that's being sent from the brain, and you'll find that before long you can have that movement. And adjust your position often to think about, you know, shoulders back, spine straight, hand open, arm stretched. Just go ahead and do some of that, you know, movement, and that helps against the cramping. If you need to, you can wear braces like I do on my lower limbs. Let's see if I can do a little bit of a yoga pose for you here. So here is my left leg, and you'll see that it has this leg brace that goes down the leg and then out the foot. And that helps with the spasticity in the leg, because otherwise what often happens is the toes will curl under. And you might think that the foot would come up, but it doesn't. It drops. It's called foot drop, and that's actually quite common for some people. So you've got the curled toes and the dropped foot, and you can't really walk. So the leg brace keeps that nice and straight and at a 90 degree angle so that you can walk. There's not very good ankle movement in that, but the other option's worse. So you make do, right? Sometimes, now I've been really exercising and strengthening my muscles, so right now I've been doing pretty good. But sometimes I, for instance, need a leg brace, and that goes across my knee. It connects to that bottom brace, goes across my knee and up to my thigh. And you'll notice that it has built-in things to help with the kicking and the moving when you walk to help control that. So you might rely on braces. You might rely on physical exercises and stretching, yoga, relaxation, hypnosis. There's also medication and potentially surgery to cut certain tendons or things to stop that cramping. But I would encourage you, as best as you can, follow your doctor's advice, of course, but talk with them. Sometimes I think they underestimate our body's ability to heal and our own mental ability to improve our physical state. Mind over matter. It really does work. So if you are looking for any help, feel free to contact me, contact your medical care provider or your physical therapist. Always be mindful of safety concerns. If you are a family member or friend with someone with spasticity, muscle rubs can really help. Handrails on all stairs for safety. Grab rails near toilets in showers can be very important and help with stability. Make sure you have those little sticky strips on the bottom of the tub so it's a traction kind of surface. Help them with stretches if that is nice. Grabby tools, help them with their braces when they need help getting that on. The people that get your assistance, I'm sure, are really thankful for it. So next time you see someone, you can understand the struggles perhaps that they're facing. Help hold open a door or just give them a smile and say hello. A little act of kindness goes a long way. I hope you have a great week. As always, thank you so much for watching. Feel free to contact me on my Facebook page or at psychologytoday.com. You can find me there. Otherwise, miigwech. Thank you. And as always, I wish the good life for all of us. Shemino bima adizi wan. Until next time. Bye.